Hi, today I'm going to tell you how little field simulation works. On this ribbon, you can see the day number, the team name, and the current cash balance. The initial cash balance given by the little field was 1 million, and these days means every hour this day is going to change. Now let's come to the customer order. This is the team name, this is the maximum work in progress limit, and every job contains 60 kits, and the current contract number is 2. That means we are operating under contract 2. You can change the contract number from the edit data. For example, the quoted lead time for contract 1 is 7 days, and the maximum lead time for the contract 1 is 14 days. That means whatever the demand we are receiving from the customer, the company has to complete all those demands within 7 days for to receive the maximum revenue. If you are exceeding beyond the 7 days, the revenue will be decreased. But if you are exceeding beyond the 14 days, the revenue will be zero. So for example, where we are operating in contract 2, that means we are completing all the demands within 1 day. And therefore, we are receiving for every job $1,000. I haven't made any changes, but when you made any of the changes, just update it. Then there is second option, that is plot job arrivals. Here we can see how many jobs the customer is giving to us every day. So, for example, at this day, we have received 9 jobs. 9 jobs means like you can multiply it by 60 and that many kits we have to complete it. Okay, the third option is plot queued job. In case you are not left with the inventory or all the machines are overloaded and you are not meeting the demands, so the jobs are going to be queued here. For example, we have experienced this scenario 3 times, and that was because our inventory was zero. That's why we experienced this scenario. So you have to monitor your inventory and you have to make your changes in the inventory according to the demands. Now let's come to the inventory part. Click on this button. Now, for example, every kit or every unit will cost you $10, and whenever you are ordering the inventory, you are giving $1,000 every time. That means along with the amount for the inventory purchasing plus the addition of this ordering cost. The lead time is 4 days. That means whenever you are ordering the inventory, it will take around 4 days to receive to the company. Then this is the reorder point and order quantity. You can change the reorder point and order quantity from the edit data. I'm not making any changes. So this means whenever your inventory reaches at this level, it is going to automatically order these many kits. You can see the chart from here. This uplift is going to show at this point the inventory was ordered. Now currently, let's see at this day how much inventory we are left with. So currently we have 5,700 inventory, and as soon as it is going to hit the 2700, it is going to automatically order 7,200 kits. Yeah. Then this is the processing unit. So we have 3 stations here, station 1, station 2, and the station 3. The station 3 is the slowest one, and the station 2 is the highest one. That means it has the highest processing speed. So when you click this, you can see how many jobs are queued at station 1. So for example, you can see like at the day 193, here we can see here. So at the day 193, we had 607 jobs queued, and that was not a good idea. And that may be because we received a lot of demand at this particular day. So right now we can see how many jobs are queued. So it's 27. That is good enough. This machines can complete it. Now if we click on this, you can see the plot utilization. That is how much the machines are we utilizing. For example, you can see at station 1, machines are pretty preoccupied. Let's see the percentage. It is 60% occupied, so it's good. Whenever you see a lot of 100%, that is 1, it is an indication that you have to buy a machine, or in future the demands are going to increase and your machine will be overloaded. So by default, at every station, you have one machine. But here you can see 2, that means we have bought 1. So currently at station 1, we have 2 machines working under the scheduling policy FIFO, and the purchasing cost is this much. And if you resell the machine, you are going to receive this much cost. So now let's come to station 2 and let's see how many jobs are queued at station 2. So you can see it is very low. The amount is very low. That is good. That is good. It is completing all the jobs. It is receiving the input from station 1, that is step 2, and from the station 3, that is step 4. So let's see the plot utilization of this machine. The plot utilization is also under 1. That means you don't need to buy any machine, or it is not overloaded. But you can see here it was around 1. It was operating 100%. So we bought one machine here. So currently we have 2 machines in station 2. And the main thing is here you can change the scheduling policy from here. That is FIFO. First in, first out, priority to step 2 and priority to step 4. Currently, we have fixed it to priority step 4. That is because station 3 is operating at the lowest speed, and this is the pre-finished product, and this is the output of this station is the pre-finished product. It just need to be tested and it is going to be the completed job. That is very good for us because it is going to gain us the revenue. That's why we have given the priority to step 4. Now let's come to step station 3. Let's see the queue jobs. So there are very less number of queue jobs. That is good. That is good. But here you can see at this time, the number of jobs were very high, 2,749. So that means it was indicating you have to buy the machine at this station. Now let's see the plot utilization. So currently we have 3 machines. That means we bought 2 machines at station 3 because the station 3 has the lowest processing speed. From the plot utilization, you can see that it was reaching 100%. That's where we bought our second machine, and this was the position where we bought our third machine. And currently it is under 100%, so it's okay. We don't need to buy any of the machine. Now come to the completed jobs. In the completed job, you can see, you can compare with the incoming demands. And here for the contract 1, the color is black. For the contract 2, the color is red. And for the contract 3, the color is green. Currently, we are operating in contract 2. That's why you can see the red color. And we are meeting 11 jobs right now. Then this is the important one to see. That is the lead time, because by seeing this, by analyzing it, we can change our contracts from the customer demands. So currently, we need to complete all the orders within 1 day to receive the $1,000. So let's see the lead time. So the lead time is 0.5 57, that is really good. That means we must be gaining $1,000. That's the maximum revenue. And if it is going to be lower than 0.5, I think we should switch to contract 3. Let's see in 1 or 2 days. That is 1 or 2 hours. So the revenue, because our lead time is less than 0.5, so we are receiving the maximum revenue. Now, this is the overall standing. Here you can see all the teams and you can compare your position with other teams. Currently, our team is on first position and this is the default team. You are going to see this team whenever you are registering. It's just for the comparison. If you are doing nothing, your balance would be this much. And these are the two other teams. Then this is the history. Here you can see all the activities or all the changes you have done. So these are the changes we have done. These are the day number. Like at day number 60, we bought a machine in the third station. And the total value was now 2 machines. So this is the whole activities we have done. Then the cash, you can see the cash. The starting cash was 1 million and the revenue is this much and the interest is this much. So you're going to gain 10% of interest annually. That is good. That means you must have more cash so as to get the maximum interest. And because we have purchased 1 machine here, 1 machine here, and 2 machines here. So in all, overall, we have purchased 4 machines. And this will cost you 90,000. This will cost you 80,000. And this will cost you 100,000. So addition of all these. So we have spent around this much money in buying the machines. And we have spent this much amount from the start to buy the inventory. So overall cash is this much. You can plot the cash. And you can see like, our cash decreased during this phase. Now it is again increasing. Then this is to just to update, like for example, it's 76 here and 190th day. Let's update and see the changes. So it's 198 day, that is the same, but our cash has increased. Earlier it was 76, now it's 79. And quit is just to close down it. So this was our whole little field simulation. Strategies are, for example, when the little field simulation is starting, just buy a machine at station 3, then at station 1, and after around more than 100 days, you should buy a machine at station 2 and then station 3. And you need to change the reorder points and the order quantity according to the demands. And according to the lead time, you need to change the contract number here, so as to get the maximum revenue. This was it. If you have any question, just text me in the comments below. Thank you.